Yeah, oh my Lord, watch me sway. Darkness falls and we all pray, hoping for the light of day. Down to the river, I have held the devil's hand, felt the weight of my own sin, burdened by the heart of man. Down to the river, down to the river.
G-Shrek, I tell you what, man, we probably took one of the worst roads. You know, we rank roads as we go in, and I'm going to tell you what, man, you talk about a tough road. We're at a tough road. And what might even be tougher than the road is what we've got to climb. So that's what's on the table today, right there. And for you that don't know, that is Delta. Now, Delta Fort. So we're in a vicinity out here off of 17 where there are four forts. And, you know, we're doing a little study about forts because, you know, our thought process is the warfare in the Southwest. You know, why would they want to build these fortresses up here? Look at that peak up there. There's about 30 feet that we're gonna have to find the path. Now, supposedly there's two paths up there, so we're gonna have to find the path to get to the top of that. And we got a time check, it was about 8:25 when we went there, when we started. So we're gonna be able to see how long it's gonna take us to get up there and see what kind of climb it really is. It's not going to be easy, but I don't think it's going to be completely terrible as long as we find that right chute. But, you know, what we want to discuss today is this. Okay, what would motivate them to build that fort up there? Well, I mean, self-preservation, right? That makes sense. And that means, though, that there was warring going on, right? They were afraid for their lives, right? It's that simple. And so the funny thing about this area, there are actually four forts within about a window of about 3 miles, right? So why was there four forts? And that's what's kind of funny about this is, you know, why were there four forts in this small vicinity? And where did these groups come from that had to have these forts? We're gonna do a little experiment today. And we're going to look at this in two different situations. The first one we're gonna look at is, if I wanted to get at people up there, let's say that we run low on food and we had to get up there because maybe they had some type of provisions up there. Or maybe they did something hostile to us and retaliation. And I needed to get up that hill. Now I can tell you on the other side, which would be more northeasterly, it's a sheer cliff. You're not going up that side. So if you're coming up this hill, how are you going to assault this hill? Now the funny thing we're gonna do is when we get to the top, we're kinda gonna do the opposite. What would it have been like back in those days to know that you have your enemies coming up this hill and this ridgeline? And now how are you going to defend yourself? Can you imagine getting hit with a rock that they were throwing off that hill? Or bow and arrows, depending on the era? Or spears at atlatl? Can you imagine the fear in yourself coming up this hill, knowing that you got definitely a disadvantage on how to get up that hill? And so, wow, we're expecting to see walls up here, and this is called Delta. And man, this was one of the forts, of the four forts. Now the rest of the forts, this way, two, and then one this way. So we've got Delta, we got Charlie, we got Bravo. Wow, I tell you what, can you imagine what it would feel like to be coming up this hill? Thank goodness the sun's come out, it's warmed up a little bit. Can you imagine what it would have taken to go up this hill and the work that would have been? How many guys would have taken to defend that hill, and how many guys would it have taken to take that hill? And you know, they didn't build it for fun. They built it because they believed they were going to need it, because the amount of work it would have taken to build that would have been phenomenal. It would have been absolutely incredible, the manpower it would have taken to build this fort. So they knew how the average person was going to have to go up this hill. And so they would have been able to defend this hill. And now, how would I have attacked it? Get as close to the wall as you possibly could. Work your way up the ridge and then look for... Now, there's only supposed to be two ways to get up this hill. And so if there's only two ways to get up this hill, it would have been very easy to defend it. You know, a couple of people with rocks, from what the article I read, and that makes total sense, you know, could have defended and held off a whole group of people. And again, this is one of the forts that are still really well preserved, and probably because of the same reason it was a great fort, because the access on this is pretty, it's pretty incredibly difficult. And so we're going to work our way up, take our time, not to overexert ourselves. But man, would you want to sneak up here at night? You know, would that have been a better advantage you might have had by working yourself up this ridge? Well, I'll tell you what. You'd have had to have been a tough guy to be able to live back in those days. Now, they believe the warring period was somewhere, what, about 1250, 13 to up to 1450. And before that, because the population was a lot lighter, you know, you'd had to have a group of people to really attack and to be on the offensive to get up there. But, you know, it would have been a difficult time. You know, I'm already going to tell you that it's going to be harder coming down than it was going up. This loose soil that I'm getting into, it's not bad going up, but I tell you what, coming down, that's going to be the difficult situation. A lot of chola, one in the leg already, and we're going to wake her. There's a kind of a creek we're going to try to get up here. Can you imagine having boulders being thrown at you? Even down here, I feel like they could have really, even when you got into 30 yards or so, 40 yards, that they could have put you in a position that would have been extremely difficult. You'd had to have a hell of a grudge for whatever reason, or be unbelievably. Now, the other thing about up there is, you know, your water supply. You know, what about your water supply up there? How long could you stay? That's another thing to think about. And then they had to haul that water supply up there. You know, we always had a theory in ancient times, whether it be Euro-American time or ancient times, you must have always been somewhat thirsty back in your day. Because, you know, finding water and the inability to be able to carry it with you would have been difficult. So just look at that. What a daunting task we have to try to assault that ridge, to be able to assault that. Now we're coming into what I'd say is the last third, right? You hear me breathing a little deep right now, because, you know, I've worked my way up here. But here would be our charge up this hill. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine what it would have been like to ramp up this hill? knowing that you only probably got one or two places that you can get in. How incredible is that? Now, we got a steep drive, and I tell you what, with no vegetation today, man, like I said, it's gonna be slick on the way down. Now we're gonna S across like this, like ski slope, right? And we're gonna traverse our way back. You know, if we get real excited, we can go straight up, but we'll probably take our time, and we'll definitely take our time on the way down. The other forts are over here, and there's three of them. Why would they have needed three forts? That is something we need to look at in this small vicinity. You wouldn't have thought the population would have been that big, right? Why would they need three forts, or four forts, actually? You know, I'm looking down here, and what I'm thinking as I'm panting, right, is that not only do I have to charge this hill, I'm having to duck for cover. So let's say, for example, they're just chucking rocks. The problem is those rocks are going to carry momentum. They don't have to be far enough to throw down here, right? And you know, they would have been a Patrick Mahomes back in the day, right? And they could have chucked some rocks. And so even down here, you'd be taking cover as they were throwing rocks at you. And you know, not only are you trying to pick your right path, you would have had rocks being thrown at you. And man, the big rocks and catching momentum and then hitting loose rocks and the rock slide that would be coming this way. And you know, they're desperate to keep you out of there, and you're desperate to try to get in. My gosh, it would have been an unbelievable situation as you go up here. So like I said, this journey is gonna be more about coming down than it is getting up. I'm just thankful today that John and Maria aren't on the top chucking rocks at me. That'd suck. I guess as long as they give me a ride home, I'd be okay with that. But so we're going up, and this is a steep. I mean, we're not crawling by no means, but it's gonna be an interesting journey coming down this hill. That's for sure. There's where we're going. I didn't look at my watch to see how far so far it's taken us to get there. 8:47, 25, 35, 45. Hell, we're 20 minutes. That's not bad. That's not bad. So, again, envision guys up there on them rocks, throwing rocks. I'm getting ready to go into what I'd call kind of the dead zone, right? This is where you would have to be so careful not to get hit by rocks in this vicinity. It'd been unbelievable. It really would have been incredible. You know, right now it's getting a little, it's not as steep as it was that little ridge right there, but it's pretty close. Now I'll traverse down there, but I can envision them up there checking rocks. Even if they didn't have arrows, just rocks. And how incredible it would have been that we would, you know, what would I do? What I would do is I would hug those rocks up there along the ridge line. Let's say I had a dozen warriors, and I would inch my way up to the different rock sections. So I would get close as I can. I'd run one over here and one over there, split their forces on the top so they'd be thrown at each one. I would line those ridges right there and get up close where they couldn't hit me. And then I would formulate everybody together, and we would slowly work our way up to that area right there. I'd have a diversion here of somebody here trying to run up, and then I would ease my men to try to get up that. But the disadvantage you would have is, you know, they're above you. And you know, you get hit with a 20 pound rock, you know, coming up that groove right there. Man, I'm telling you what, you're talking about something that would have been extremely difficult to get up. Defending would be a lot easier than getting up there. Now I'm gonna take my time, and hopefully if I do fall, I fall down and to my face and not backwards. So I'm gonna work my way across this ridge, which is extremely slick, as you can hear the rocks kind of sliding under my shoes. We're gonna work across here. Ease through here. Try to find a path. And make it up to the ridge line. But you know, now I gotta fight somebody. You'd have had to rest. You'd have had to prepare. You'd have to be mentally prepared to die up on this hill. Because that's what would be. So, whew. Man, we're gonna take our time coming down, that's for sure. So I tell you what, coming down, it's going to suck. Whew. So, with my men, what I'd do, I'd get up on this rock and hug it. I'd hug this bridge through here and then work my way slowly, trying to find cover anywhere I could, as they're just chucking rocks at you, breaking your cranium in half. Man, you know, I said in that article, I wonder if they understood what a beauty this land was, how incredible this was. We're almost there. We're at the end of the assault up the hill. So one last push and we'll get up there. But tell you what, you're gonna be careful on this because this is slick. Like I said, again, here I am looking down and I would have boulders coming down on my head as we speak. And then again, I've got to get down this just as well. That's a scary rock. Is it slid out? Well, there's where I gotta go. So again, coming down, it's gonna be a pain in the ass. There's where I gotta go. Rocks coming from all sides. Well, we're definitely gonna take our time going down once we get up, but here's what we got. So we got left. A couple more. See some graffiti up here. And some petroglyphs right there. So let's get the last push. Let's get the last push on here. And then work our way up this. Hear me hard, breathing hard. Got my auto still on. So I only got a couple more rocks to push around to get up there. We're almost up there now. You know, as I'm sitting down here, just kind of gathering my thoughts and resting. Now, I'd have had to fought multiple battles if I could have even got up that hill. So if I'm on this defensible position, you really got to want me really bad, because I've got this, I got defenses. And what an incredible place up here. This is just unbelievable. We're going to take a look around before we get into this and just see what's here. I'll tell you what, this is an incredible place. Look at these walls right here. They'd have come right up to the edge, right? So we'd have been right in here. Look at that wall. Look at that defensible position. Just incredible what an advantage you'd have if you had a couple dozen people up here defending this position. It would have been incredible. You would have definitely had the advantage. The view is phenomenal. Nobody could have snuck up on you. Look at this wall. Look at this unbelievable wall here. This is just a thing of beauty. I just am always inspired when I see these walls and the workmanship it would have taken to do this work.
Yeah, oh my Lord, watch me sway. Darkness falls and we all pray, hoping for the light of day down to the river.